Hi there, welcome to Pixelescope. This is the second part of the Krita Assistant tutorial series. If you haven't watched the first part, get the link in the left side of the screen. So, without further ado, let's get started. Let's start from Spline. Spline is a curve and you get two handles to manipulate the curve. So you start by clicking anywhere in the canvas, even outside the drawing area. So I click here and I have released the click, and then you have to click once again to confirm the limit of the spline. So I'm clicking here. Then you get the first handle and that sets your curvature of the line. And once you click again to confirm the location of your first handle, then you get the second handle. And by this method, you get very precise curve, and then you can move it and then maybe edit the pivot points, and then you go to the brush menu, and if you haven't ticked it, you have to tick the assistant and then get started. So the use case of these curves I think should be where in the stylized rendering, especially in comics drawing, where you want a very precise curve drawing. So it is really convenient to use in that scenario. And you can combine multiple splines and then you get a really easy to draw. Actually, this is really more effective than the brush stabilizer, because you cannot get outside this predefined curve. So there's that. Let's explore other tools. Let's explore ellipse. And as the name suggests, it draws an ellipse, and its usage is really specific. And what you do is, at first you click on a place anywhere in the screen, and then you specify the one of the axes. It can be major, it can be minor, depends on your choice. And then you click once again to confirm the first axis, and then you get the second axis. And notice that if I go out of the scope, it just vanishes. And once you click once again, then the ellipse will be confirmed. And then you go to brush and then draw here, and that's your ellipse. This is really specific at what it does, but it does it very well. Let's explore our next tool, that is concentric ellipse. Now this is an ellipse already, but it extends the usage. So how is that? Let's explore. You start by drawing the ellipse same as before, and then you go to your brush, and notice I am not bound to drawing a single ellipse. I can draw any ellipse that is concentric to this ellipse. I think this is more useful than the previous one, as it helps you draw multiple ellipses at once. So the next one, perspective. Now this is really cool tool, and all you have to do is specify the points, and after the third point, notice the perspective shape. And this is that, it helps you draw the perspective, and this X above the perspective shape is your vanishing point, and there is your second vanishing point on the left of the shape. And once you click this is your perspective. And the coolest feature of this is you can extend this perspective and then shape it accordingly, and then you can get this to vanishing point at one place, and this can be used as a room. So this is cool, really cool. And I can draw some basic shapes here, just so conveniently. But notice one thing, I have to start inside this perspective in order to get my drawing. If I draw outside the perspective, the drawing will not happen. So but if I start from here and extend to outside, the drawing will extend. So there's that. I think this is one of the best features that Krita has to offer. You can use this in various scenarios, in sci-fi building, just building, spaceship, gun, I don't think gun, but anything that has perspective. So this was the second part of Krita Assistant tutorial series. If you found this video helpful, please like, comment and share. Also, if you are new to this channel, then please subscribe and hit the bell icon so that you don't miss out any new upload from my channel. So that's it for today, guys. I'll see you in the next tutorial.